Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create an agenda for a board meeting or an annual general meeting and then save it as a template. So the first thing I'm going to do, I've got an ordinary document, default document here. I'm just going to press the return key a few times. That's going to allow me to put some graphics at the top here and some headings. So I'm going to go to insert. I'm going to go to table, click on the drop down. And for this agenda, I'm going to need three columns and just go down to as many rows as possible. My table's been inserted here, but the rows are a bit narrow. So I'm going to select the whole table. I can click on this upper left square, or I can just click and drag across the whole table. I'm then going to go up to layout. Then I'm going to go to height here. I'm going to select that total. And I'm going to put 0.8 in there and press enter. This has just made my rows a bit taller, and I'm also just going to change where my text will lie when I begin to type. So if you go back up to layout, if layout isn't there, it's because you haven't selected your table. So select the table, go to layout, and then go over to this section here. And it's in this section where you can tell Word where you want your text to lie within your cell. So I'm going to go to align to center left, and you can see those blue shadings move to the center of my cell. So now I'm just going to input some of my text. This will dictate how wide my columns will be. So let's just go ahead and begin with host. We're going to put in the name of our host, and then we're going to merge these two cells together. So select them both, go to layout and go to merge cells. And you can see now that's merged into one cell. Then we're going to go down to attendees. And then once again, we're going to merge these two cells together, select them, go to layout and merge cells. And then you're just going to input all of the people who are going to attend the meeting. So I'll speed up the video and put those in. So now I'm just going to leave a space and begin the rest of my table. Now, the table will not look like this. All I'm doing at the moment is just inputting all of the information. Then at the end, we're going to sort out the look of it, change some of the fonts. We're going to change the lines and border lines around the table. And then we're going to put some graphics in at the top to make this look really professional. So we want these three columns here for the time, the topic, and the presenter of the meeting. So I'm not just going to put in fake text. I'm actually going to put in some really helpful text here that if you are trying to develop an agenda for your meeting, then you can use this template to put exactly what you want. I'm just going to move these columns over, but the way in which I know how much room to give each slot is by putting the time in here. So I'm going to use the 24-hour clock, but you can choose whatever you want. And I'm just going to put everything in 15-minute increments. Now for this particular one, because I want to make this row a little bit smaller, I'm just going to pull it over. You just click on it and pull, wait till it changes to this double-headed arrow. What I am actually going to do is select this row here, go to home, and I'm going to change the font size to 10. What this will do is allow me just some extra room for my titles and my presenters. I'm going to move the presenter over. But I need more room for my topic titles and my topics, the content of my topics as well. So that's now been adjusted. So every time I type in this row here, that time will come up as that font. And I'll show you why in a second. So let's go to our first topic. I'm going to put one. So if this happens to you, just click on this drop down here and select undo automatic numbering. I'm just going to put in my text and my presenter. And you can see roughly from the names up here, I'm going to need not too much space for the presenter. So I can just move that all the way over to there. So now I've roughly got the size or the width size of my columns to ensure that I can get everything in. So now I'm just going to put in the topic. And then once I've done all this, I'm going to leave a space. But as you can see, I haven't got many more rows. So the way to add more rows, if you click in the bottom right cell, and hit on your keyboard or select it, go to layout and just keep clicking on insert below. And this way, you can just insert as many rows as you want. So I'm just going to keep clicking, and I'm going to take this down to a second page because we will need a second page, and leave it roughly about here. So now I'm going to go ahead and put on our next timings. And it's going to be the second element of the meeting. And we'll just put in one more presenter. Now you get the idea of what we're doing. I'm just going to put all the other information into this agenda and then come back and I'll show you how to customize it all. So now I've got my content. So now I need to make this look a little bit more professional. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn these two here bold. So select them both, go to the Home tab, select bold. And again, I'm going to select these three and turn those bold as well. The next thing I'm going to do is turn this bold and increase the font size. So I'm going to increase the font size by going to this icon here and clicking, and then to bold and click there. Now I've done two actions there, which I then want to use on the next title here on number two. So without having to go back and click on all of those customizations, if I click on this tool here that says Painter, Copy Formatting, just click on it, you can see my cursor's changed to a painting brush. If I just click and drag over the whole of that, you can see it changes and it's exactly the same as the one above. Go back up to the Painter, do exactly the same on the next one, and so on and so forth. The next thing I want to do is actually split this table. So at the moment, this is one table and it's connected. But I actually want to split it because I've got this funny thing at the top here, which is an extra wide cell that is in some way connected to this one here. So I'm going to click in this cell here, go to Layout, and click on Split Table. So now I've split this table. All I'm going to do is I'm just going to put my cursor at the top left here. I'm going to lift this table up and see if it makes a difference. And you can see there's obviously some return keys in here. So I'm just going to delete these. There we go. And delete them again. And now we have two separate tables. And I know that because if I click here, this square comes up at the top left. If this was one table, this square would not appear. So I'm going to go down to the bottom here. You see my cursor's at the bottom of the table. Just hit my return key and you can see now that those tables are perfectly lined up. However, I want to get some graphics at the top here. So I'm going to just nudge this table down a couple more. So you can see my cursor's at the top here. Just press the return key. I'm going to press it twice. You can see that the table above has jumped to the second page, but there's quite a gap at the bottom here. So I'm going to go over to my rulers. If you can't see all rulers, go to View and make sure rulers are checked here. Hover between the white and grey section and then click and drag down your margins. And this just decreases your margin size at the bottom, giving you a little bit more space in the main part of the document. So you can see my page has jumped a little now. So I'm going to move that down and they're perfectly level for page one and page two. And then I'm going to put some graphics in at the top. But before I do that, I'm just going to go down to this section here because I want to put in notes. So I'm just going to type notes in here and I'm just going to make that bold, click on bold and just increase the font size of that. Perfect. Now with notes, you just want plain lines. You don't necessarily want all these column splits here. So I'm just going to select the row, go to layout, and click on merge cells. And then the shorter way to do this is click on this one, merge this plain one here, and then delete these two, because when you place a cell below, just click OK to that. You click in here, if you insert a cell below, it will replicate the cell above or the row above. So if we create the cell we want or the row we want, and just duplicate it, we won't have to merge all of those cells. Okay, let's go back one. So now we've got all our notes in. First thing I'm going to do is take all the lines out. So click on select your table, go to table design and go along to borders, click on the drop down, and select no borders. So you can see everything's been taken out. However, you can't really see what you're doing. So select it, go to borders, click on the drop down and select view grid lines. Now when you view the grid lines, they are there purely as a guide. If you were to print this out or save it as a PDF, none of these lines would exist. It's purely a guide for Word. So let's do the same with this one. Go to borders, click on no borders. It's there anyway, so I can just click. So now we can see our tables and we can see all of the lines. We can select which border lines or any lines we want to select and put them in this document. So the first one is if I select this row here, I want to put, let's just select the row. I want to put a line below all of these here. So select it, go to table design, go to borders, click on the drop down. You can see this option here that says bottom border, and you can see there's actually a line indicating where the border will go once you've selected your cells. So I'm going to click bottom border. And as you can see, we've got a line here. Now, if you want to customize the line, you can go to pen color. You can choose any color you like. You can change the thickness of the line if you want to. And you can also change the look of the line as well. So those are the customizations. So I'm going to go ahead and do that to all of these. Once you've selected the bottom border, you can see it's already selected on this icon. So you don't have to click on the drop down, just click on the icon and it will put that borderline in for you. So I'm just going to go ahead and do all that and speed up the video. Okay, now that's done, I want to do the same with all of these as well. Now for this one, if I select borders below or bottom borders, I'm only going to get one at the bottom. So I've got to click on the drop down and go to this one here that says inside horizontal border. And you can see the border line that will be placed inside my selection. So click on that and you can see now I've got all of those border lines selected. So once again, let's have a look at what our layout looks like. Click on the drop down and take out view grid lines. And that's what it looks like so far. So let's quickly put some page numbers in. Double click at the bottom of your page and you'll be in footers. Make sure you're in headers and footers tab at the top. Go to page numbers, click on page numbers. I'm going to align mine to the center and click OK. And then double click inside the main part of your document and you'll go back into the main section. So at the top here, we're just going to put a little bit of text and graphics just to make this more professional. Now, if you want it on both pages, you can do it one of two ways. We can put in the graphics, copy and paste it to the other page, which is very simple to do. Or you can create the graphics and put them in the headers and footers. The easiest thing is to create them in the headers and footers, then it will be copied across to the other page automatically. However, it is grayed out, so if you do want to send this as a document, it will be slightly grayed out at the top. But if you want to print this out, once it's printed, it will look absolutely fine. So for this, I'm just going to create it as normal, just in the main document. So I'm going to go up to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and select the square. Click and drag out a square or a rectangle and make sure it stretches across the top of your page. Then I'm going to go to Shape Format, click on this icon here that says Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Border. If you want to change the color of your shape, it's here. You can select from any color here. If you don't see the color you like, go to More Fill Colors, and you've got the color wheel here that you can select any color you like. So I'm going to select that color, and then I'm going to copy and paste it by clicking on it, hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag out another one. Deselect them both and just reselect this bottom one. I'm just going to make this bottom one a little bit smaller, and I'm going to change the color to a light blue. And then I'm just going to put it underneath here. Then I'm going to put in some text. So I'm going to go to Insert, Text Box, Draw Text Box. And then I'm going to click and draw out a text box. And in this text box, I'm going to put Annual General Meeting. And then I'm just going to move it up to this section here. And then I'm going to keep it selected, go to Shape Format, click on the borders and select No Outline. Click on Shape Fill and select No Fill. And then I'm going to select the text, go to the Home tab. I'm going to select white, just select white. And then I'm going to increase the size of this text. until I'm happy. And then I'm going to deselect it, reselect it because we were inside the text. Again, hold down your Alt key, click and drag. We copy that one across. And in here, I'm simply going to put the time and date of the meeting. So for this, it's really eyeballing in where you want this text to lie within this box. You can move your arrow keys. I'm going to try to get the M here lined up with the edge. And the annual general meeting, I'm just going to make that a little bit bigger. Once again, using my arrow keys, I'll move that across. You can align them by selecting this text box, holding down the Command or Control key, selecting this one, go to Shape Format, go to Align, and then Align to Left, and then those two will be perfectly lined up. So check you're happy with everything. I'm just going to move this blue border or this blue rectangle up a bit. And the same with this one, just move that one up a bit. Perfect. Now, as soon as you're happy with it, I'm going to group it together. So I'm going to select this box here, hold down your Command and Control key, and select the blue box behind. Select the light blue box, keeping that Control or Command key down. Click on the date box here. Go to Shape Format, go to Group, and select Group. And now this is one group. If you want to make any changes to it, simply go back to Group, click on the drop down and select Ungroup, and then you can go back and make your changes. But if you're perfectly happy with it, let's click on this and then just hold your Alt or Option key down and then just click and drag out another one. Now, if you haven't got that facility, then simply click on it, go to the Home tab and press on Copy, deselect, and then select Paste. And you can just simply copy and paste it to the other page. Okay, so once you've got everything in place and you're perfectly happy with it, you can save this as a template. So when you save it as a template, you can go in at any time and just redo this. You can just make changes to the document and then Word will ask you to save it as a brand new document so you don't spoil the original. So to do that, go to File, Save as Template. Make sure you're on this Templates file here. And make sure the file format is Microsoft Word templates. Save it as your document. So we'll just put in agenda and then just click save. Now you won't see anything happen, but if I open up Word, you'll see you've got templates at the top. Select more templates and go to the personal section here. And in here, you'll see your agenda document. And when you click on that, it will open a brand new document. It will open this document up as you see it. But it will mean that when you go to save it, it will ask you to save it as a new document. So it will always be saved in your templates. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.